Welcome to SINUMERIK Live, Application Technology Simply Explained. This series of videos was created to present in a concise manner individual topics on this application with the SINUMERIK, consisting of short slideshows and reports of real applications. Today's topic is the DXF Reader. Faster turnaround from drawing to finished workpiece. We'll also illustrate the possibilities and limitations. Today's agenda: what is DXF? Why do you need a so-called DXF reader directly on your controller? Given the tool is installed directly on the SINUMERIK, how does it work? What are its possibilities and limitations? What functionalities does it offer exactly? Here we have the first item on our agenda. What is DXF? DXF is a type of data format. DXF stands for Drawing Interchange Format and is a specific file type. This format has established itself as more or less the standard for data exchange on the market, meaning every CAD/CAM program uses it today. This file is open documented so that all CAD/CAM writers are able to import the data into another program and manipulate it. It is specifically used for the data exchange between different programs or operating systems. Let us address the second point. How do I open DXF data files? How do I create them and use them? This is actually a very interesting question. There are various ways to do this. Let's focus on two. One way the files are created are by a CAM system. In our case, the NX CAM by Siemens. The NX CAM, seen on the left, is able to directly generate a solid model of a workpiece using so-called solids after converting the DXF format. How does this work? Open a file in NX with a tool. The so-called three-dimensional solid can be turned, rotated, zoomed in on, and can also be viewed from all sides in detail. At this point, the solid needs to be broken down in a two-dimensional plane. This means a top-down view. This can be done using the so-called DXF converter. The file is exported into an AutoCAD DXF DWG format. In this window, you can see the export file name. Click Next, and the work view is changed to a top-down view. The DXF is then re-imported into this chosen view. Click Finish, as shown in the top left, to start the DXF converter. It will analyze the piece and store the relevant information for the top-down view. The process has now finished and the file is now available in DXF format. When a new file is opened, we can view this DXF file again by doing the reverse, by importing. Simply select the file in a DXF WG format from the directory you've created. Open the file. The DXF format is checked automatically. The format is automatically read in, which then automatically triggers the top-down view. The workpiece is projected on an XY plane with all the relevant information, showing the piece in a plan view. Use the 3D mouse to see all the details on the projection. Let's look at the next point. Why do you need a DXF reader directly on your controller? Why is the DXF reader implemented directly on the controller? DXF data files can be loaded directly in the SINUMERIK controller. These contours used to have to be typed in manually. Now, the turning and milling contours can be read in automatically without the need for a lot of data conversion. This means the user can make immediate use of the contours. Those complex calculations are now a thing of the past. The circle center, intersection point and radii are all measured automatically, as the contour is generated automatically by the controller. The contour can also be automatically generated in shop mill and in shop turn, whether you're dealing with complex or simple contours. As the viewer, we may consider the contours on the right complex. This bicycle contour is also manifestly complex. Whether we are dealing with a simple contour, with one such as this, or as the one visible to the right, it's all the same to the contour processor. Now let's consider the question, how does the DXF reader work directly on the SINUMERIK? How is it managed? And how do I manage the data? This data is read into the SINUMERIK externally and then processed further. Here's a practical example of how the generated DXF data can be read into the SINUMERIK directly. There are two ways to do it. Either use shop mill, also shop turn in analog, or program guide in G-code. Let's first consider shop mill. Contour milling, new contour. Here you must give a program name. OK. Now select the DXF file in the Explorer directory. Here we have this bag. Usually, we would need to define it manually, which means each individual line segment in the coordinate system. This is done as follows. We select our initial element. Use your finger to tap select on the multi-touch display and accept. OK. Given this contour element is closed, the controller has of course recognized it as such. Then we select OK. We want to capture precisely this point that is shown in the contour processor. All that typing and step-by-step programming is not necessary at this point, given how the DXF file is read in. That reduces the required time by a solid 80%. Capture, and the contour is combined with the corresponding technology. Here also, testing the simulation, i.e., what exactly have I done here? That's important so that you guarantee the program is correct preliminarily. Yes, here we have our exact point, the point that we programmed. When all you need to do is click Capture and Close Contour, that obviously takes only a few seconds. As pointed out earlier, the whole programming process is hugely accelerated. Another way you could do the same thing is by using the G-code. Open a program for Program Guide and select Contour Milling, New Contour. Here you also need to add a name. Optional, Capture. Here is our DXF file again. As before. Select the bag you want. Capture contour. Exactly the same process as before. OK. The reading in of the G-code program and the generating of the G-code program takes as much time as it does in shop mill. The invaluable advantage here is, of course, that of time saved, as this would usually need to be typed in manually. This is, of course, a great relief. Now, having covered the practical simulator example, here is a short summary. We can test drawings, as regards the actual component after the simulation, on the correct toolpaths, collision avoidance, and we can manage the layers while processing the DXF data. The same applies to the geometric elements. As shown, we can generate contours and then select to output them in shop mill, shop turn, or in the G-code as root commands. Now that we've shown you the possibilities offered by using the DXF reader with the SINUMERIK, here are a few more words on the aspects that need to be considered when using the DXF reader. We of course depend greatly on the quality of the DXF data, which is dependent on the design. What can happen with a messy design is you have design errors, as in lines, such as you can see here, that do not connect properly with the edges. We can of course easily solve this by repairing those affected elements and closing the gaps. This is an advantage of using the SINUMERIK with the DXF reader, where you have the interface and controls directly on the machine. Of course, with this setup, it makes sense to plug in an input device, like a good old mouse, so that you can navigate properly. A summary of the advantages of using the DXF application on the SINUMERIK. Is DXF sufficient as a CAD interface? Definitely. Only the truly relevant information is read in. The biggest wins of this tool? Time saved and process reliability when generating contours.